Hi, my name is Michael Roman, and I'm a 36-year veteran with Wells Fargo and Company. And welcome to Leadership Lessons from Drag Performers. Today, you'll meet panelists, each from different lines of business and backgrounds. What we have in common is that we perform in drag. Our panel has discovered that the traits and leadership skills that we've learned through our drag artistry align very closely with that of collaborative leaders. You're going to hear from each of the panelists how we take those skills and bring them into the workplace and in our daily lives. What's this session all about? For me, it's to learn to be vulnerable. The more you share of yourself, the more you'll be able to connect with your teams and your coworkers. Just like we do with our audiences. That's what a good drag performer must excel at. So why is this seminar about drag? Well, let me quote RuPaul. We're all born naked and the rest is drag. Each day when you get up, you make decisions. Those decisions are drag. What you're going to wear, what color you're going to wear, your attitude, how you choose to present yourself in a meeting, how prepared you are for the meeting, that is your drag. And that leads to the art of persuasion. Drag is not always all venom and sarcasm and shade, and even when it is, it's so that we can persuade people to our opinion, to our point of view. The art of persuasion is about getting to know your audience as well, but also to get them to buy into your point of view. So with that, I just discussed the top two of the 10 traits that we're going to discuss today of collaborative leaders. The first half of this session is pre-recorded, so please submit questions. We'll answer those questions live in the last half hour. Let me introduce our next panelist. Connie Taylor, she's got a different opinion and a different way and a point of view how she brings these traits into her daily life. So Connie, let's hear it.
Well, thank you, Rhoda, and so nice to see you again. I'm Bruce Thompson, AKA Connie Taylor. And my drag story begins all the way back in high school when I was in a high school play where I needed to dress in drag, which was hilarious because I believe it was a homemade dress, which was part of what started my desire and interest in sewing my own costumes. In terms of drag, it continued throughout the years for Halloween and parties and the occasional night out until a few years back, I ended up hopping on the stage for the very first time in a small town in Iowa with a bunch of friends. I was hooked at that point. I had so much fun. It was where I felt my drag needed to go beyond just Halloween and parties. And since then, back up in Minneapolis, I have been able to enter many of these open mic nights or talent shows and have, you know, won more than I've not. And as a result, I've really enjoyed my time with drag, and it has taken me now into a whole nother realm of performing for benefits, performing for salon openings, sometimes performing in a murder mystery party where we're all in drag, and cabaret shows, and it's been a blast, and I'm really, really, truly enjoying my newfound drag persona. As far as work and leadership and drag, for me, it really is about awareness and trust. I recently moved from one suburb to another into a brand new development, and probably the only LGBTQ person in this diverse neighborhood. And what I was concerned about was whether or not I would share my drag persona with my neighbors, or rather, how I would share my drag persona with my neighbors, because I knew at some point I would. Drag has given me a lot more trust in myself and my performances, and trust in my decisions, just as I am as a leader. I'm very aware of who I am as a leader, very aware of the type of leader that I want to be and have been. And I'm very trusting in my decisions as a leader. And a lot of that has also come from drag as well over the years. So I ended up sharing with my neighbors, Connie And at my housewarming party, the drag room / sewing studio where all of Connie's costumes and wigs are was the highlight of the tour. In addition to becoming more confident and aware of who I am, it's also helped in many other parts of my leadership. I've recently am in the process of looking for a new position. And when it comes to my leadership and what I'm looking for with a new role, I have the confidence of being able to truly be myself, being fully authentic to who I am and aware of the fact that if I am not truly authentic, I don't feel like I am leading myself down the path that I want to. Drag is also, in my mind, opening more doors for me, both from a career perspective, as well as from a drag perspective, in terms of creating costumes for others and building that sisterhood that I never really had in the beginning of my drag career, but I know many people have, and I know Nikki will share a little bit about that. So I think it's an amazing journey that this has taken me on. And I attribute a lot of the drag qualities that I have learned from performance and character building into my leadership in my day job, specifically that trusting of who I am as a person, as a leader, aware of who I am as a person and as a leader, and aware of my surroundings. So those are the two traits that I feel most recently I have really been able to glean from my drag career. And I'm very proud of the work that my drag has taken me to this point. So thank you for listening to my story.
Hi, my name is Nick Lind, or Nikki Love, as some call me. I've been with Wells Fargo for about 7 years, five of which have been in a leadership capacity. And I can attribute a lot of the reasons that I was in a leadership capacity to Nikki Love. I'm Nikki Love, or Nick, as I go by in my day job. I've been performing in drag for 10 as of this year. I work on the weekends at the Garden Show Lounge here in Des Moines, Iowa. There were days when the sun was so where I've been a part of the show cast for a couple of years. It's a lot of fun and it's a lot of work, just as being a leader is as well. The traits that I'm going to be talking about, influencing, delivery, partnering, and professionalism. But I want to take a step back and talk about my beginnings here of getting into drag. So I grew up watching my mom do her makeup every day, and she'd do the rollers and the makeup and sit in front of the mirror and get all glamorous. She was one of the types that didn't even go to the grocery store without hair and makeup. And so it was very fun to watch, and I was just in awe with it. Unfortunately, she passed away in 2011. So this was kind of my way to carry on her legacy and have that connection with her. When I get ready in the mirror, I feel like she's still there with me. Definitely being a leader is about being able to let people in and be vulnerable as well as influencing others. What do you do with your spotlight? As a drag queen, we have a spotlight on us at all times. When you walk into the room, you're full of bling and glitter, and all the eyes are on you. So it's being able to use that spotlight for good and to send a clear and concise message to your audience and leave your mark and just make sure that what you're doing is spreading light and positivity and getting that message across, whether it's to your audience or your team members. Another trait that I want to cover is partnering. I'm part of the House of Love, so we travel around Iowa doing various Pride events. We put on a 30 to 60 minute production, so it's all choreographed, matching costumes. It's very fun. So we never actually get a chance to rehearse face to face. It's all video going back and forth. So it's a lot of accountability and being able to partner with each other for those that do live in the same area to be able to meet up and do the rehearsals and what have you. And then the day before the show, we have a full day of finally a face-to-face rehearsal where we throw everything together, and then we produce an amazing show. So this last one that we did was in Waterloo. We had an audience of about 3,500, and they were going crazy, so they loved it. We've been together for about, I've been with House of Love for 10 years. They've been together for about 20. It's a great sisterhood to be a part of, and we all love each other and care about each other and check in with each other, just as leaders should do with their employees and team members as well. Leaders also possess the ability to deliver under pressure. So doing this whole House of Love performance that we did, we were definitely under pressure to deliver and get the message across with our performance, which we definitely did.
Thank you very much, Nikki, and for sharing that really wonderful story. That's another example of vulnerability, but thanks for sharing today about influencing and partnering. We've reached at least 3/4 of the traits of collaborative leaders. Now we're going to move on to David Aloka.
Hi, everyone. My name is David Aloka, also known as David Flores. I'm a branch manager with Wells Fargo. When I'm not dressed as a boy in a suit and tie and beard, I shave it all off, throw on a wig, put on some heels that are about this big, and walk around the city, be known as David Aloka. I've been with Wells Fargo since 2012, so I'm coming up with 10 years with the organization. But David Aloka has been around since 2014. How she came about was by volunteering with the Alliance for Housing and Healing for a fundraiser called Best in Drag Show. Best in Drag Show is a fundraiser that raises money for people living with HIV and AIDS that are homeless in Los Angeles. And when I first came to the show, I saw the amazing work that all the people and the volunteers were doing. You know, I went in just to see a drag show and I thought it was going to be a fun time. Then hearing the testaments of the clients that are there and the work that they do within the community was something that was really left me in awe. You know, you talk about going to a show and there's a roller coaster of emotions when you're laughing, crying, mad, angry, upset. I had all of those. So I realized from 2012, I can only sit in the audience for about 2 years, and I had to be on stage. Hence, what you see in front of you, David Aloka.
I need a hero. I'm holding out for a hero till the end of the night.
Since 2012, when I became an employee with Wells Fargo, I realized that the Wells Fargo Foundation loved to give to nonprofit organizations that help people like the clients that are at the Alliance for Housing and Healing. So I was able to make a connection with the Wells Fargo Foundation and the organization. Since then, Wells Fargo has donated almost consistently every year to them. Bringing Davita to work is not something that I do. This is a costume. You know, David goes to work and he's the branch manager. But when David's not at work, he goes out into the community and he fundraises for this amazing organization and other organizations whenever they wanted, you know, a beautiful person to just host an event. You know, because I was able to bring my true authentic self to work and then show my team how David raises money for these people who are just trying to get a bite to eat, who are trying to get assistance with paying their utility bills. That really enabled them to be able to bring their true authentic self to work and to kind of think outside of the box of fundraising. You know, a lot of the volunteering and fundraising that we do, we think we're gonna, you know, do a walk or we're going to, you know, sell cookies or something. You know, they never realized that dressing up in drag can raise a lot of money. You know, that show Best in Drag Show, we put it on once a year, we fill up the Orpheum Theater and we raise about $500,000 every single year. You know, there's a crowned winner at the end. I've competed twice, won 0, not bitter at all, just keeping track. But I just wanted to make sure that the people know when they go to Best in Drag Show, there's no cash in prize. There's no $100,000 check in a year's worth of supply of makeup. We do it for fun. We do it for free. And we do it because it gives back to the community. You know, in 2018, I was Volunteer of the Year with Wells Fargo because of my volunteer efforts. And I never thought that applying for a bank and working behind a desk would allow me to be able to get recognition for something that, you know, you don't think banking would do. You know, in 2018, I got the opportunity to ride the Wells Fargo Stagecoach, and that was an amazing Woo-hoo! Accomplishment that I had.
She made it to the top.
Because of my volunteerism and the passion that I have for volunteering, the LA volunteer chapter asked me to join, and I was the co-chair for the volunteer chapter. And being able to marry the two worlds together, I was able to show my line of business that you don't have to separate who you are at work. You get to bring your true authentic self to work. You get to be creative. You know, volunteering in person, that was an amazing thing that a lot of us got to do. But then the pandemic happened and we had to think outside of the box on how we're able to still volunteer. You know, while a lot of us were stuck at home or having to work from home, I remembered the clients that the Alliance serves and they don't have a home. They're homeless. But we still, as drag queens, have an obligation and a responsibility to go out into the world and then promote joy. You know, we promote joy and I have the opportunity to get a couple donations out of it as well. So in 2020, instead of filling up the Orpheum Theater, we rented out the Rose Bowl and did a drive-in drag theater. You know, you would think that it wouldn't be that big of a deal. It made a big deal to these clients because we were able to raise about the same amount of money that we would have had over at the Orpheum that one night at the Rose Bowl. You know, there's us, you know, in drag, and you know, no one wants to cover their pretty face, but we're in a pandemic, so you know what, we threw on a mask but made sure it had glitter on it. Becoming a drag queen, volunteering, you know, think outside of the box. Don't worry about trying to separate who you are from your daytime job. At least I don't have to do that anymore because I'm fortunate with the company that I work for, and I got to be able to see how when David becomes Davida, it's the same person, but I get to be able to do a lot of amazing things when I'm dressed like this, because this gets attention. I'm 6'1" as a guy, and I'm like 6'7" as a woman. So with that, thank you so much for your time, and I hope you guys enjoyed the rest of the presentation.
Thanks, Davida. That was very insightful. We did get to cover a lot of the traits of collaborative leaders. We're gonna continue in a moment live to talk about some of the other traits that we haven't covered. We'll be answering your questions as they come in through the online chat. So thanks for your participation.